Hello and welcome. My name is Manuel Quintana with Pragmatic Works, and in collaboration with MAQ Software, we're bringing you today's video to showcase their custom visual known as the ratings visual. This custom visual is going to give us the capability of doing some scoring, rating, whether it be from movies, surveys, but it gives us a plethora of different visualizations. It could serve as indicators. We have some great opportunities on scaling on how we want to do it. And even some elements into the idea of normalization. It's a very simple yet effective custom visual to allow us to display any sort of ratings that or averages that we want to display within our Power BI reports. So let's head right over and take a look at the ratings custom visual by MAQ Software. So here we can see we're working with a data set that gives a list of employees with their departments and their relevant ratings that they have given us. This could be for a survey of quality, happiness, whatever it might be. Very common in any sort of organization. And we can see we have access to many different shapes, and we have the capability actually of configuring the number of actual indicators that we'd like. And of course, formats such as color and that are completely in our control. In our scenario, we can see in this first one, we're simply taking the average of all of our employees across all departments, and we get an average of 3.1. If we look at the available mapping fields here, we have value and maximum value. Maximum value isn't required, it is optional. The only one that is dependent is our value area. Maximum value comes into play with normalization, which we'll look at in just a moment. But we can see, of course, any traditional filters can be applied. In this regard, we're doing the average rating of only the employees from the development department. So here there's a visual level filter for that. And we can see in the tooltip, we've also indicated as such. When we go into the formatting of this visual itself, we can see that we have control over the actual configurations as far as which shape we'd like to use, how many indicators. So if I just hit the up arrow here, we can see that that increases, but the value still shades in. So 3.1 of our, in this case, triangles is being shaded. We also have the capability of making a gradient fill if we so choose. Now that gradient also, we choose the starting color and the ending color of that. And we can also make sure that the background for those that don't get a fill, also what color that would be represented. So gradient is also an option for us. As we can see here, it's a little more pronounced when we do that because the 3.5 is a little bit more filled. Or we can just specify the filling itself. So you can see quite a few options. We also can do an indication for the border itself. So as you can see, it's now just specified as a black border and the width, so if we want it a little more pronounced. And also we have the animation, which by default is on, and as we've already seen it, it just kind of fills it from left to right. In regards to normalization, we do have that capability if we take advantage of the option here known as maximum value. Here we're basically taking whatever we place inside of the value, we divide that by the maximum value, and then multiply that by the number of indicators that we have specified. We take that remaining value and that is leveraged as a percentage, and that percentage is then what is filled with the number of indicators we have. So in our example, we've made it very straightforward as far as making the number of stars 10. If our value is 10 and we divide that by 31, we get a value of 0.32 rounded. And then from there, we multiply that by the number of stars, which gives us 32%. Hence, in this case, since we have a nice, clean, easy 10 stars, 3.2 of those will be then filled. So we can add a level of normalization here, which is really neat, and it's a great feature to have in addition to this element. So just remember, tons of various options when it comes to formatting, animations, gradient scales, and of course, we have complete control over legends, titles, elements such as that. So hopefully you're ready to use the Ratings Custom Visual by MAQ Software. So thanks for watching our video. If you have any questions about this visual or need a similar business solution, feel free to contact MAQ Software at sales@maqsoftware.com. As well, for any of your Power BI training needs, be sure to reach out to us at Pragmatic Works by emailing training@pragmaticworks.com. Take care.